my community, if somebody is deaf, you are abused, that you are kasiru, in our language, that means stupid. So that hurt me very much. It kept me worried for a long time. People were looking at me like I was nothing. I had entered a new world with no experience, but I never gave up. I gained confidence, and my mother felt pity because I was deaf, and she felt so bad why I was staying home and why people were referring to me as stupid. So she tried to get somewhere to place me, and I was placed at a deaf school in Ntinda, that is in Kampala suburbs. So in there, I felt so good because I was able to communicate with the other children who were deaf in that school. But it was true that although I went to a special school, I really wanted to know what was going on with hearing students or pupils. When I finished that school, I passed very well my class 7 exams. I was integrated in a secondary school. That was in a place called Mora. It is in eastern Uganda. It's an integrated school. So I went there for my first levels of secondary school. I continued up to 6 years education. And I plan now to join university and to learn non-governmental management skills. So I feel as a deaf person, I'm proud. I have achieved a lot. I have worked hard. I lost my hearing, but I never gave up. I've continued to be deaf, and I've met so many other deaf people. I know that other people are learning a lot, and we share with them. I'm learning a lot. Even when I'm deaf, I learn. And I've seen that other disabled persons have managed to go up to university, and I know I can. We are dreaming a lot. We are dreaming about inclusion. We are dreaming about quality education. We are dreaming about human rights. We are dreaming about many things, but we know that we shall achieve that. It is, people may say it is impossible, but I say it is possible, and the future is very bright. We ourselves must show, we must show the inspiration as Africans, and we will be able to improve to reach the high levels of our lives.